Hello! In this video, I'm going to cover CubicleSoft File Tracker, the multi-project, multi-host, bulk, visual diff merge tool for Windows, Mac OS X, and Linux. File Tracker is useful for scenarios where it is challenging to keep multiple copies or near copies of many different files in sync across many different projects on an ongoing basis. File Tracker assists in making quick work of the problem of locating all matching files of interest, showing the differences between many copies of similar files, applying desired changes, committing to project repositories, and pushing to upstreams such as GitHub. File Tracker can efficiently track files both locally and across multiple hosts over SSH. This allows you to have a single central location for tracking all files of interest across all accessible systems. There is even a fully featured interactive SSH client built in. File Tracker is very affordable. A single license covers you or your whole team and includes a year of product support and software updates. Visit cubiclesoft.com to learn more about File Tracker and to purchase a license. The rest of this video is a tutorial showing the basics of File Tracker in action. When running File Tracker for the first time, go to the Edit Configuration portion of the application. Here, various options can be set to configure what portions of the local system are scanned, and to also configure optional external tools. Next, add all of the files to track in the Manage Files section. For this video, I've added both http.php and sso_http.php to a single file group. A file group contains one or more file names of files that are identical or nearly identical. For example, sso_http.php is a slight variant of http.php that tended to lag pretty far behind the latest version due to being a slight variant. With File Tracker, I can easily keep it in sync with the mainline software branch. I'll also add a few other file groups just to make things more realistic. After setting up a few file groups, run a full synchronization to locate all instances of each file across configured systems. There are a number of different scan options for precise control of each scan. File Tracker never applies any changes to a system until Synchronize runs. Before looking at any new files that were found, make a quick stop at Manage Projects. Projects leverage the automatic commit and push version control features of File Tracker. At the bottom of the page, File Tracker will show possible new project locations based on the files it found during the last scan. I'll set up one new project, and then with the magic of video editing, I'll skip to the end of the process. Once the project list is settled, it is time to move on to Manage Files. Here we can see the scan found 11 different versions of http.php and sso_http.php spanned across 51 different locations on two different systems. When new files appear, the next step is to go into locations for the file group and check to see what has been added to make minor adjustments as necessary. For the http.php file group, I treat the sso_http.php and a couple of very old files a bit differently. Specifically, I want to track most instances of sso_http.php, but not change them, and therefore I have disabled all but one. I also have a really old project I want to leave alone until I have time to deal with it later. I've disabled the entire project, which implicitly disables any file locations associated with that project. I am also protecting specific sections of the sso_http.php file that I do want to modify, and prevent the file from becoming a default source. The next step is to use the process diffs option of Manage Files to plan out a merge operation. File Tracker thinks for a few moments and then delivers an at-a-glance visual diff of all the versions of the file against the selected source file. The default source file can be changed, and automatic selection of the source file depends on the rules for the locations in the file group. But the default behavior is to select the most recently modified version of the file as the source. The source file in File Tracker is usually the leftmost view in a traditional visual diff merge tool. Think of the source here as being the left-hand side of many, possibly hundreds of files simultaneously on the right-hand side. Each time a new file diff is encountered, a little badge appears for that entry, which allows for quickly scanning through many diffs. My own goal is to keep the number of different versions of any given file down to no more than 2 to 3 different versions at any given time. I like these changes as is, so I'll press the Save button. File Tracker has now scheduled the selected file changes for the next synchronize operation. Normally, I'd go down the entire list of file groups and repeat the process for each file being tracked. But for the sake of shortening this video, we'll move on to the next step. Next, return to Manage Projects and schedule the various commits and pushes for the next synchronize operation. I'm happy with these changes, so I'll press the Save button. File Tracker is now ready to change files, commit code, and push to upstream repositories. Until I synchronize, I can go back and make adjustments as needed. Finally, go over to Synchronize and run another full sync operation. In just a couple of minutes, all of the queued changes, commits, and pushes are run, and the systems are scanned again. This particular synchronization resulted in updating 17 projects on GitHub with the latest version of each file. Instead of taking several hours, this whole process took just a few minutes, and I remained in total control of the process. File Tracker also supports tracking files on remote SSH hosts. Adding an SSH host is a multi-step process. Set up the SSH key to use for the new host, if any. Then add a SSH profile and configure the scan locations for the host. Then test the connection. Deploy the File Tracker remote software. And finally run Synchronize. The Connect option for each SSH profile starts a fully featured and interactive SSH client that connects to the SSH host, which is useful for quickly accessing information on the host. This concludes the overview of and tutorial for File Tracker. Head on over to the CubicleSoft website to learn more about File Tracker and to purchase a license. Be sure to like and subscribe, and thank you for watching. We'll be right back.